So I want to talk about something that has been on my mind for a while now. It's the upcoming RTX 4060 Ti graphics card from Nvidia. I know many of you are probably excited about this card, but I have got some really bad news for you guys. RTX 4060 Ti will be dead on arrival. And this is because it is going to offer a minuscule 10% performance gain over its predecessor, the RTX 3060 Ti. And on top of that, this card is going to cost hundreds of dollars more than RTX 3060 Ti. First of all, let me preface by saying that my analysis is based on leaked specs from Copite7 Kimi, who has a pretty good track record when it comes to GPU leaks. So what's the problem with RTX 4060 Ti? Well, it's going to be based on AD106 GPU configuration, which comes with only 4,352 CUDA cores. To put that in perspective, the newly released RTX 4070 Ti, which is based on AD104 GPU configuration, it came with 7,680 CUDA cores. So RTX 4060 Ti has 76.5% less CUDA cores than RTX 4070 Ti. Now you guys might be wondering, so what? What do CUDA cores have to do with anything? Well, the typical performance of an Nvidia GPU is proportional to the number of CUDA cores that it has. To give an example, let's take a look at this chart, which compares the number of CUDA cores present in the RTX 3070 Ti versus the RTX 3060 Ti. As you can see here, the RTX 3070 Ti has 26.3% more CUDA cores than the RTX 3060 Ti. And guess what? The RTX 3070 Ti outperforms the RTX 3060 Ti by roughly the same amount in synthetic benchmarks. In fact, in the 3DMark TimeSpy benchmark, the RTX 3070 Ti is 27.97% faster than RTX 3060 Ti. Okay, so what does all this mean? It means that we can accurately estimate the performance of RTX 4060 Ti by just comparing its CUDA core count with RTX 4070 Ti. We already know that RTX 4070 Ti has about 76.5% more CUDA cores than RTX 4060 Ti. So this means that RTX 4060 Ti should be about 76.5% slower than RTX 4070 Ti. Now let's take a look at the 3DMark SPI benchmark score for RTX 4070 Ti. Now this card is already out and we have definite benchmarks for this card, and it's scoring 22,652 points in this benchmark. So if my analysis is correct, then RTX 4060 Ti should score around 12,836 points, and this is basically 76.5% slower than RTX 4070 Ti. And if that's the case, then the RTX 4060 Ti is going to be a terrible value for money. It will only be around 10% faster than the RTX 3060 Ti. In fact, the RTX 3070 Ti scores 14,835 points in the same 3DMark TimeSpy benchmark. And that makes it about 15% faster than RTX 4060 Ti. So unless RTX 4060 Ti is priced similar to RTX 3060 Ti, I just don't see why anybody would be interested in buying this card. Well, if you are on a tight budget, I would skip RTX 4060 Ti and I would go with RTX 3060 Ti. So that's the card that I have here right now. Now, I was lucky enough to get my hands on the Founders Edition of RTX 3060 Ti during last summer. And this was because my local Best Buy was selling this card for $399 and I was able to get a hand on this card. At that time, they had plenty in stock, but unfortunately, at the time of making today's video, I went and checked out Best Buy's website and all these cards are now sold out. You can still get the overclocked RTX 3060 Ti from board partners, but some of those cards are selling for around $550, which I think is just plain stupid. Now, I know some of you might be thinking, well, I will just go with an AMD card, right? What's the big deal? And I think that's definitely a good option for gamers, but since I mostly use my GPU for video editing in DaVinci Resolve, unfortunately, I'm stuck with Nvidia. I don't have a choice. Now I expect RTX 4060 Ti to be priced somewhere around $599 to $650. And this is based on the current pricing of RTX 4070 Ti and Jensen's greed and hubris, which means that RTX 4060 Ti is not going to be a good value for the money because we have already seen that its performance is not that good and it's going to be priced a lot more than RTX 3060 Ti. Honestly, this whole situation really grinds my gears. Are you freaking kidding me, Nvidia? The crypto market has crashed and scalpers are now losing their shirts, yet you are still behaving like we are in the middle of a crypto boom and you are expecting consumers to pay crazy price for your GPUs. Do you have no empathy or understanding of the current market conditions? I think it's completely outrageous and a complete slap in the face of loyal customers who have been supporting your brand for all these years. I think it's high time that Nvidia wakes up and realizes that the crypto market is not where it was once, and it's time for them to adjust their GPU pricing and show some decency towards their customers, especially gamers. But if money is no object for you and if you want the absolute best GPU for video editing, then check out this video over here. In this video, I take a closer look at the latest Puget Bench results comparing the video editing performance of RTX 4090 and AMD RX 7900 XTX. So go ahead and watch that video and I will see you guys over there. Bye.